Welcome to today's lesson on positivity. In today's lesson on positivity, we'll be reading the book Ish by Peter Reynolds. I also included a bonus song at the end, Think Positive. Our message is, I can spread positive energy. And during our mindful moment, we'll reflect on how we can be a positive good friend. So what does it mean to be positive? Being positive means I think positive thoughts. I believe in myself. I am optimistic. And I have a growth mindset. Let's read and learn more.
Ish by Peter H. Reynolds. Raymond loved to draw anytime, anything, and anywhere. One day, Raymond was drawing a vase of flowers. His brother Leon leaned over his shoulder. Leon burst out laughing. "What is that?" he asked. Raymond could not even answer. He just crumpled up the drawing and threw it across the room. Leon's laughter haunted Raymond. He kept trying to make his drawings look right, but they never did. After many months and many crumpled sheets of paper, Raymond put his pencil down. "I'm done." Mirza, his sister, was watching him. "What do you want?" he snapped.
"I was watching you draw," she said.
Raymond sneered. "I'm not drawing. Go away." Mirza ran away, but not before picking up a crumpled sheet of paper. "Hey, come back here with that!" Raymond raced after Marisol, up the hall and into her room. He was about to yell but fell silent when he saw his sister's walls. He stared at the crumpled gallery. "This is one of my favorites," Marisol said, pointing. "That was supposed to be a vase of flowers," Raymond said, "but it doesn't look like one."
"Well, it looks vase-ish," she exclaimed.
"Vase-ish?" Raymond looked closer. Then he studied all the drawings on Marisol's wall and began to see them in a whole new way. "They do look ish," he said. Raymond felt light and energized. Thinking ishly allowed his ideas to flow freely. He began to draw what he felt, loose lines, quickly springing out, without worry. Raymond once again drew and drew the world around him. Making an ish drawing felt wonderful. He filled his journals, tree-ish, house-ish, boat-ish, afternoon-ish, fish-ish, sun-ish. Raymond realized he could draw ish feelings, too. Peace-ish, silly-ish, excited-ish. His ish art inspired ish writing. He wasn't sure if he was writing poems, but he knew they were poem-ish. Ponder, pond, ponder, dream yonder, pond, pond, yond, yond. Gleam Wander by Raymond. One spring morning, Raymond had a wonderful feeling. It was a feeling that even ish words and ish drawings could not capture. He decided not to capture it. Instead, he simply savored it. And Raymond lived ishfully ever after.
So let's review. Being positive means that I believe in myself. I believe I can achieve. No matter what, I believe I can reach my goals. That's having a growth mindset. I am optimistic. I know that I have an awesome future, even when things don't go as planned. And I have a growth mindset. I know that a major part of learning is overcoming challenges. This means I know that part of learning is to make mistakes or not do a perfect job. Those mistakes help me learn, and so I treat them as positive things, not things that get me down. Feeling positive also means we have our self-control flow. Be positive that you can make choices that lead to the best outcomes for you and others. When you follow our self-control flow, it'll help you feel more positive. Remember, positive self-talk, or those thoughts in your head, plus positive feelings like happiness or calmness that we practice with our mindfulness, equal positive choices that you make and will lead to positive outcomes. Sometimes negative events or negative people can try to mess up your positivity, but stay focused on what you can control. Remember, your reaction to negative events and people are based on your thoughts, feelings, and choice of action. So if somebody negative does something to you, your thoughts, feelings, and choices are still in your control. You have the choice. Even when someone else says to be negative, you have the choice to stay positive. Part of our Pal Panther way is to choose positivity. Your positive energy leads to positive outcomes for other people too. That's right. Even if somebody's negative and you choose to stay positive, your positivity will spread. Here's a wonderful video to explain more about what I mean. When we choose positivity, we have to choose it everywhere, including the cafeteria. So when you're in the cafeteria, choose to have positive chatter or positive talk. Think about happy topics to talk to your classmates about, like your favorite things to do or watch or listen to, best moments from your week or weekend, a joke that you just read or learned. Fill your mind with positive topics. You know I love to fill my mind with talking about animals like puppies and kittens. Wonder what are some positive topics you guys could talk about at lunch. Remember, choosing positivity means you're not gossiping or spreading rumors about other people, because that's not positive. Think before you speak. Is it true? Is it helpful? Is it inspiring? Is it necessary? Is it kind? And don't forget to use good manners. When we chew with our mouth closed or wait to speak until we've swallowed, when we don't interrupt others or throw trash in the floor, that also spreads positivity among the cafeteria. In today's mindful moment, we're going to take a moment to think about how we can be a good friend. One way to be a good friend is to spread positivity to others. When you're positive, your friends will feel more positive.
Think about it. Sit or stand up straight. Take a deep breath and follow along. Think of a time when you needed a friend. Someone to help you out. Maybe you needed them to listen. Or to just be there for you. Just be with you. It felt good, right? You can be that kind of friend, that kind of support to others. Find a moment to be a good friend today. Notice when somebody needs you. Decide to be there for them. Offer to help. Maybe you just listen to their story. You giggle at their joke or say, "Yep, I see what you mean." Friendship is not about a big thing. It's about a million little things. Things you can do every day. Be a good friend today.
Let's take a moment to reflect. Why is it important to think positive? Spreading positive energy can encourage others to do the same thing. So think about it. When you're in the cafeteria, what are those positive topics you can talk about? How can you spread your own positive energy to others?